Obviously, people are being very critical of my lifestyle and everything, which I don't know.
Look,
Yeah.
don't worry about the haters, man. You know,
Sneako is another young gentleman who decided to sell himself or his soul into Islam. I'm sorry, I meant who decided to become a Muslim. It become a fashion for people to sell themselves, sell their soul into Islam to justify their awful lifestyle. In his recent interviews, I'm sure everyone picked up he has no knowledge of Islam. Reason he become a Muslim, apparently, he was amazed how there are no supernatural events in Islam, which clearly someone who didn't even bother to look into Islam. In his recent conversation with Islamic Dawah gangs, member of the Islamic Dawah gangs, he's expressing that people are pointing out that his morally publicly corrupted life. He lives in a sin, and he says, "What do you advise me? So far, as a Muslim, I am trying to do last 3 weeks. I went to Friday prayers. I try to do 2 prayers out of 5 prayers. But what should I do about my corrupted, sinful public life?" And you will be amazed how Islamic the answer is. That's why people sell their soul into Islam, because Islam is there to justify their sin.
But what do you think the next steps as a new revert, because you've probably seen a lot of people,
yeah.
What do you think the next steps are? I've been going to Jummah prayer for the past 3 weeks.
Excellent.
I think that's what people were recommending I do. Obviously, people are being very critical of my lifestyle and everything, which I don't know.
Look,
yeah.
Don't worry about the haters, man. You know, I deal with this kind of stuff all day long. People that hate, they're just going to hate. You're new in Islam. Alhamdulillah, Islam is not something that, you know, you want to get overwhelmed by. You want to take it step by step. The wife of the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, Aisha radiallahu anha, she said a beautiful hadith. It's a statement of hers. She said that if Islam, when it was revealed in the beginning, the first rules in Mecca were, don't drink, don't gamble, don't fornicate, don't do anything, people wouldn't have been able to handle it. So in the beginning in Mecca, it was all about increasing your faith, gaining your knowledge. And then when the companions of the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, when they went to Medina and they were able to handle it, then all the rulings and regulations started to come. The first thing I suggest for you is don't worry about what people say, increase your faith, increase your knowledge. I'll send you some videos we made on the evolution, step by step. We made them on how to pray step by step. The most important action in Islam is the 5-time prayers. You got to get on your prayers. You know, whatever bad habits you may have, inshallah, when you are praying properly and correctly and on time, those bad habits will start going away.
Yeah, it's absolutely fine. You continue to live your life. And whenever you think it's the right time, you can simply give it up. Whenever the right time comes, however you feel comfortable. Think about it. If you point out someone's morally corrupted life to that person, apparently according to Islam, according to Muslim missionaries, you are a hater. Telling your brother or your sister you live in a sin, it's a hate. Yeah, that's the world of Islam. You don't get that in somewhere else. You get that in Islam. Have you picked up? Those are the same individuals do not take Aisha's word when Aisha expresses that Muhammad climbed top of her when she was a child. She was only 9 years old, Aisha says, when Muhammad climbed top of her. And no one believed her. Muslim missionaries, these very Muslim missionaries, don't believe in her. Yet now, when they need to sell Islam to these new converts who sold their soul into Islam, what they do is they go with Aisha's word. Yeah. You can live, and justification is awful by itself. Continue to live your life in sin. And whenever is the right time for you, you just give it up if you can. Islam celebrates sin. Morally corrupted individuals become Muslim to justify their sin and then get their green light in Islam. This is what it is.
Also, such as celebrities, unrepentant sinners, continue to join into Islam, they will help Islam to collapse.
That is wrong. Wages of sin is death. Sin is terrible thing. Especially sins which has been publicly known needs public repentance. Those celebrities jumps into Islam, to justify their sin. Sadly, they don't even know what they are signed up for. Doesn't matter you are celebrity, you are whoever you are. You might be king, you might be queen, you might be professor, or you are just a teenager who is struggling with the life. You've got to repent from your sin. You've got to bring your sin into the feet of Lord Jesus Christ, who by his death and his resurrection conquered it.